Welcome to this session on how to create and run test suite in Catalon Studio. In this session, we are going to see what is a test suite and how do we create and run a test suite in Catalon Studio. We will also look at some useful tips. Let's get started. So what is a test suite? So test suite in very simple words is a collection of test cases, and it is a logical collection. And with that, we mean that the test cases are grouped into logical categories. Let us take an example. You have multiple test cases for your application. Some of these test cases will be for login, some others will be for transaction, and then there will be some test cases for logout. So we can categorize and group these test cases accordingly into test suite. So there will be a test suite where we can group all the login test cases. Similarly, we can group the transaction and the logout test cases. And therefore, we can create these logical categories for all the test cases in our application. Let us see how do we create and run test suite in Catalon Studio. I'm going to my Catalon Studio, and here you can see, if you go to test cases, these are the three test cases that we created in our earlier sessions. Now we are going to create a test suite. So let us go to this new button and select test suite. You can give any name. I'm saying test suite 1, and hit the OK button. And we have this test suite created. So let us look into this test suite window. Here you can go to this add button, and as soon as you will click here, you will get this test case browser, and here all your test cases will be listed out. You can do a filter by doing a search, and then you can select the test cases that you want to add to this test suite and then select OK. So you will see all these test cases are now a part of this test suite, and now you can use this move up, move down, delete buttons to edit your test suite. And if you go to this section here, the run section, you can see here are some checkboxes. So if you uncheck any of these test cases, that will not be executed as part of this particular test suite. So let us uncheck test 2, and now we can save our test suite, and now we can run it by hitting this run button. And we can run on any of these browsers. So let us select Chrome and let us run our test suite. So what it should do is it should run test case number 1 and test case number 3. It should not run test case number 2. So it is launching the Chrome browser. And it is running our test case number 1, which we recorded and created for the Orange HRM website. And this is done, and now it is running the third test case that we created for our lifecharger.org website. And yes, this is now done. And let us look at the log viewer. You can see we have got all these logs as we get while running our test cases, and all these are coming here. And what you can do is you can look at the reports by going to this report section, and you can see our test suite, and this is the report. Let us go to our report, and it is giving us all this information about the test cases. You can filter out the pass, failed, errors and incomplete from here. And then here you can see the summary, the execution settings, the execution environment. We will look into reports into more details in a separate session, but for now you can just see this. You can go to show test case details here, and then whatever test case you will select, you will get the corresponding details of that test case execution. Again, it is very handy and useful. You have this toolbar where you can select and filter out the results, and then you can look at all the logs and all the information per test case and per step. So this is how you can create and you can run your test case and you can view your report. Let us look at some useful tips. So if you go to your test suite, there is an execution information section where you can set the timeout, the retry count, you can add email recipients, and you can also look at the last run report. So let us go to our test suite section, and here you can see this section, execution information. Click here, and then here you can set the user defined timeout, or you can use the default timeout. So the default timeout is set under project settings, and if you go to execution and you go to default, you can see here is the timeout set. You can set some seconds here, or this is the default. But if you want to override it, you can override it here for your particular test suite. You can look at the last report by clicking here. It is showing me our last execution report, or you can set the retry count, and of course you would want to set it only for the failed test cases most probably, and also you can set the email recipients here. We will look into a separate section how do we configure and add email reports to our Catalon Studio. So this is how you can set the test suite configurations. Also, one of the other tip is you can create folders to categorize your test cases. So you can see here we have our test cases, but they are not categorized. So what you can do is you can create folders. I can go to new folder, and let us say I have login test cases. I will create a folder by name login, and then whatever test cases are for login, I can just move it inside this folder. So you can see this is how we can categorize our test cases. And now if we create a new test suite, let me go to new and create a test suite, and let me name it as test suite 2. And here I have got this test suite 2. If I go to add, now you can see I am getting this folder, and inside this we have these two test cases. So it will be very useful if you can categorize your test cases into folders when you have a large application and a lot of test cases. It will be very useful to categorize your test cases, which will be easy for referencing. Let us do a very quick recap. In this session we learned what is a test suite, and then we created and ran our test suite in Catalon Studio. In the next session, we are going to see how do we create test suite collection and how can we use this to run our test cases in parallel.